Welcome to the Buzz New York City Live. Today's show will not disappoint.
Yes, Deshaun, we're doing our SexTales episode and we are not holding back.
We have a live performance by the beautiful Daisy Grant.
Hey.
Who got cakes?
I do.
That's right.
Who knows how to twerk?
I sure do.
Let's talk and get it popping. So sit back and relax.
And get your buzz on! To the Buzz. I'm Deshaun, and we have our host here today.
What's up, guys? I'm Alex.
And I'm Bronson Johnson. And who is this? Oh, it's Miss Grant.
Hi, everybody.
Our
I'm
special
Daisy
co-host.
Daisy Grant. He can't find another that tastes better than me. I'm subtle, but I'm weak. Won't give you cavities. He wants my pink lemonade. My pink lemonade.
So what's been going on? I haven't seen you guys in like forever. What's up, Alex? What's been new?
You know, I just did a show off Broadway recently. Wow. I did a Shakespeare show and it was set to music and we had flappers and burlesque dancing and there was some drag in there and it was crazy.
It was a modern version of Shakespeare?
It was a modern version of Shakespeare. Macbeth. It was Macbeth.
Oh, wow. I think we got free tickets to that too.
Did you?
And I missed it.
You could have seen it. I had some righteous songs. They were good.
Thank you.
Mm. All right. And you, Bronson?
I'm actually currently changing jobs now. I'm going to another different hotel, so I'm really excited about that. It's gonna be great. Big opportunities, moving up in the world, you know. And Miss Daisy Grant, what about you? Because we know you do a little bit of singing and stuff going on, looking all fabulous, giving me a lot of music tea, but what about you? How about your normal life?
Oh, my normal life isn't normal.
Oh.
Just working, recording my album.
Okay.
Some movies that I'm
going to
be trying to get involved
okay.
in.
All right.
A few things
is
in store, so.
Okay.
We're
not mad at that. You better hustle,
Nene Lakes. Is there Mr. Grant or is there
no.
Lewis? Oh, no? Okay.
Oh, she's single.
Oh, wow. Okay, fellas.
No.
Okay, cool.
Dating is fine, though.
Okay.
Well, let's get to it, yeah?
Let's get to it.
Daisy, take us away.
Okay, if you are bootylicious like Beyonce, or if you got those cakes like Rihanna, you are not a stranger to the booty. On today's show, our host will give you the true breakdown on the power of the abs.
All right, so you point him. Get started.
Wow. I love a great ass. I can't lie.
What makes a great ass?
Let me see. Who got a really nice?
You like that Nicki Minaj booty?
Nah. That's
swallow
good.
I don't mind that.
That is nice. But you know, it has to fit her body. It just has to fit her body. It could be a little too big, but you know, just like especially when they have like the little boy shorts. What about you, Alex?
Well, I like it to all be nice and formed, you know?
Okay.
You gotta have a little waist, and I like a good curve. But if it's too big, like Nicki Minaj would be too much for me.
Oh, too much, okay.
I want something that I can delve into, but I don't want something that's gonna swallow me.
What about a fit booty? What about like a girl that looks like she works out or does squats? Like,
That's good. Yeah, it has to be together.
Like a cuff?
It can be big, but if it's big and like down, it needs to be cut, round,
okay.
Three-dimensional, spherical from all sides.
Okay, he's in this geometry runs right now.
You, Bronson? Oh, wait, hello, Bronson.
What about your booties,
Bronson?
Well, I call it bounce back booty, which means, you get the picture. That's what I like, but we're not going to go too far now. That's for sex tales. That's going to be coming up soon.
Okay.
What about you, Ms. Daisy?
I'm not into butts.
Not a man's butt like you?
Most men don't have nice butts. If you're not a football player, not realistic.
Well, she hasn't seen this clearly.
You want me to have it.
Yes, Daisy is coming for wigs, y'all. Wigs. Yes, she told me I got no booty. Oh, yeah. I ain't gonna give it to her.
Uh-huh. She's coming back. She has to come back to the show.
Yes. YBN Entertainment is gearing up for a new talk show called SexTales, which we just mentioned, in honor of their premiere on New Year's Day 2015. We are exploring everything ass. By the way, they feel to the way they jiggle. Questioning my fellow hosts, does that matter?
What?
The way they feel and the way they jiggle?
Yes.
They should be.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I mean, see, today, like, guys are into the big butts, but these women are getting procedures done to have figures.
Yes.
And natural asses aren't stiff. Or natural asses, if your ass is moving, some other things may move. It's just certain things that you, if it was real, you would know the difference. So I think that that's where it's like.
That's why I'm saying Nicki Minaj can have a big ass, but everything's packed up in there. I wonder what it's like.
She really can't move, though. It doesn't really, like, if you notice, she shakes and it doesn't really.
Now, I have an interesting question. Have you seen the waist trainers? You guys know what that is?
There's such thing as a waist trainer.
Exactly. Now, these girls are putting on these, you know, back in the days, in the Victorian days, they used to wear the corsets and curve the bodies. But they're saying now these girls are putting these things on, it's squeezing their organs. Yeah, that's all it is. But they're just like promoting this, you know, like, what's that girl's name that was with Tega? Black China.
Okay.
And Kimmy K. They all wearing these little things to put them all together. I'm just like, girls, come on
now. Well, this is no shade, no shade. But these women are getting surgery.
Of course.
And you have to put, a lot of the times, they put those things on because of their post-surgery.
Yep.
Not to train your waist to have a small waist. Okay. Now, you can slim down, but...
Just don't eat that cake.
Now, y'all hear all this. This is factual information.
She knows.
Now, she's not a booty connoisseur, but she'll tell you right that the booty should not jiggle. Yeah. It should jiggle and... feel right at the same time.
Okay.
That's right. I like this. Well, booties come with a certain action.
Okay.
We know it as twerking. Dictionary.com defines it as to dance to hip hop or pop music in a very sensual way, typically by thrusting or shaking the buttocks and hips while in a squatting or bent over position. Twerking isn't for everyone. Has it gone too far?
I dare for someone to twerk.
You gonna make me twerk?
Yeah, go. Let's go.
Well, I love it there. I love
it there. Camera three, please.
I love it.
I got it. Don't worry.
Bronson
goes. That's all y'all gonna get. That's it. You get nothing else.
Full episode.
So,
has it gone too far?
Has it gone too far?
Here's my problem with it, because twerking has been going on for years, ages. Now, because it's become mainstream, everybody wants to do it, but it's like, it's gone too far. I need to stop because it's hit mainstream. Everybody's tired of it, but we've been doing it.
I shouldn't say that.
But yes, it's been going on for a while. And I think right now, since it's mainstream, it just needs to stop because everybody wants to do it. And it's like, okay.
It's funny, though, because there's like sexy twerking, there's like weird funny twerking, there's like joking twerking, there's not like everyone who's twerking is trying to be sexy.
Right.
And it's like,
Which kind of ruins it.
To me, it's got played out.
Yeah, it's done. They're beating it with the dead horse now.
Like, everybody's just,
I mean, but really, does the give it up ever get old? And that's the original. That's the kids, them hands with the knees, it wasn't called twerking. That was the give it up and all the other stuff.
Again, factual information from the booty connoisseur.
Daisy Gray.
Daisy Gray.
That's what I'm saying, when you were younger, like, we were all younger.
Right.
You knew at the house parties.
Yep.
You knew to back up on it. Like, you know, now it's like, what are you doing? Like, why is your back and your arms, like, doing this little motion? Yeah. I was like, that doesn't match. Like, you got to let it go.
Literally, just let it go.
Like, frozen.
Later, we have a live performance from Daisy Grant.
Hey.
So we'll be right back on the buzz.
What's up, guys? We are back with the beautiful, fabulous, talented, famous Daisy Grant.
Woo!
Thank you.
So we'd love to hear a little bit about how you got to where you are now. My question for you is, being an artist on the grind as well, I'm curious to know, what was the big breakthrough moment for you? Who'd you meet? What'd you do?
I can't really say that I've actually accomplished the big breakthrough moment yet. I've done some things in my career that I'm really happy that I've been able to accomplish. But I still want the record deal. I still want the Grammy. I still want those big accolades that's that we talk about. Right. Yeah, of course. Yes. And I feel like I've gotten to where I've been working so hard to be. But so right now, I'm just still grinding.
So where you are up on this like staircase right now, how'd you get to where you are now?
If it was five stairs, I might be on a third.
Okay, cool.
In my mind.
That's great. That's great. Right. Now, you know, I'll be watching you. I'll be looking on Facebook. Okay. And you had a chance to perform at the White House.
Yes.
Like, that's, like, dope. Like, I think that's so awesome. Like, how was that experience?
It was probably the best experience I've had performing ever in my life.
Wow.
The event was based for the kids. It was the 2014 136th Annual Easter Egg Roll that they do.
Oh, wow. Cool.
So this is the biggest event that they do at the White House, and over 30,000 people come to the White House for the event. And it's all for kids. So you get genuine reactions. I had kids crying to meet me and saying how big of fans that they were and things like that. So that's something that you know it's genuine because kids are so
honest.
Super honest.
So honest.
Yeah.
So that was like really, really like heartwarming for me. But that was like so far the best thing.
Any secret services like that? Anywhere like that? Like,
well, there's snipers on every building. Every single building surrounding the White House.
Okay.
And there's certain things that you can't do, like you can't point or do anything like that.
Wow,
certain things. But it was definitely like security clearance, like the Obamas wanted to come out during like a rehearsal day, and they cleared the whole White House, all staff. Okay. Everyone had to come off until they made their way through and then went back in the house.
So okay. Wow.
It was dope though.
Yeah, there are men still walking through the front door of the White House.
Right. Yeah,
that's exactly. Crazy.
Now, what about like your album? Because I'm assuming you're working on an album.
Yes, I am working.
With that being said, would you get writing credits on it? Like, how far is that going? Like, what about the whole production of the album itself?
I've written every song.
Oh, that's
wow!
I love.
So you got
a
writer too. Wow.
Love that.
So I mean, that's the one thing that I have kind of built my name on.
Okay.
Being the songwriter,
yes.
And now I'm able to kind of like, you know, take what I've learned through the years, apply it to what I want to do as an artist, and then as well as have those people see me for who I am.
Love
my
it.
Music, so.
Now, with your writing, you got some songs from personal experience, I'm assuming.
All of my songs are personal.
Oh, wow.
And if they aren't personal, I've seen them through someone else.
Okay.
Like I've gone through it with a friend or something like that. So that's where I kind of like pull everything from. But I don't like hold anything back in my songs.
I'm excited for this.
Yes. I think that's so amazing.
I'm excited for this.
It's cool to see. I mean, when you see someone that writes all their own songs, you're really getting like them.
Yeah, yeah, that. Yep.
So that's
genuine.
Amazing.
Very genuine.
That's amazing.
And now
true artist.
Finally, I can get, because I've been writing for artists and trying to shop records for years, and now it's like, I feel like every time I wrote a song for somebody else, I was giving them a piece of me.
Right.
I was giving them something that belonged to me. So now that I can write my album, tell my story, and nobody else can say that. You know, I couldn't feel like I gave it to anybody else, so I'm excited about that.
Oh, wow.
Exciting
stuff.
True
artist. And she's from Newark, New Jersey, is that true?
Of course.
Oh, representing Brick City. Wow, okay.
You better remember this interview.
Right. Yes.
Don't forget about it.
Yeah. Wow.
Of course. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you so much.
I'm so happy to have you.
Are
so
you ready to sing then?
Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Yes.
I'm ready.
She wrote all the songs. I was sold.
Well, we'll get a little bit of that right after this break.
Live performances, live action, live hot topics, live commentary. Be a part of our live studio audience. To get free tickets to our next live show, visit whatsthebuzztv.com.
Straight out of Newark, New Jersey, give it up for the beautiful, talented
Daisy Graham.
Yeah.
Yeah. Summertime in the fall, 98 degrees inside these walls. He said it's too hot and he needs something cool. I got a special drink I made just for you. Fill it to the rim, go for seconds if you like. You will never be denied, it's unlimited supply, boy. Tastes better than me. I'm sober. I won't give you cavities. He wants my pink lemonade. My pink lemonade. My pink lemonade. He wants my pink lemonade.
And now you see what I'm made of. Cause I'm your favorite flavor. Got you messed up in the head. So go. Pink lemonade still on your taste buds. You can call on me. Just give me a good reason to make some more for you. You. And I'll be happy to.
Fill it to the rim. Go for seconds if you like.
Seconds
you
if you like.
Find you, because that was hot.
That was dope.
Definitely can find me on SoundCloud, YouTube, yes. Instagram, Twitter, everything Daisy Graham.
It's all Daisy Graham? Yeah. At Daisy Graham?
SoundCloud is soundcloud.com/Daisy. Daisy-Grant.
Daisy.
And then Instagram and Twitter is just Daisy Grant. Instagram.com/Daisy Grant. Twitter.com/Daisy Grant. On Facebook, it's Daisy Grant Music. So it's Facebook.com/Daisy Grant Music.
Y'all got all the same. Any of y'all forget that? Y'all missing out. Pink lemonade.
Hey.
Sorry. I'm not Daisy Grant, but that is.
That's
amazing. We like that.
We would love to thank our wonderful viewers who watch us online and locally here in New York. Thank you so much for watching, along with our musical guest
and co-host
and booty extraordinaire knowledge
Okay, because she showed us what was up. All
shout
right,
out to our staff and crew who worked hard in making this possible.
And make sure to visit whatsthebuzztv.com for updates on you can be a part of on our live studio audience. Look out for SexTales to premiere in January 1st, 2015. SexTales, I like that. Yeah. And everyone, this is The Buzz!
Put that back on.
Put that song back on.
Put it back on.
We got to come on, Kim.
I can't dance to nothing, Kim.
I can't do this.
What are we paying for?
I want pink lemonade.
You did again. My pink lemonade, my pink lemonade, my pink lemonade. He was my pink lemonade.
Comment and subscribe. For bios, pictures, and other shows with NewNew, just visit YoBoiNewnue.com.